You're next in line for the official Holiday World podcast.
Welcome to Holiday World and Splash and Safari.
Dropping in from Santa Claus, Indiana.
Riders will experience swift acceleration, high-speed turns, and sudden stops.
With park president and CEO, Matt Eckert.
You've learned about hootenannies and Shakespeare all in one podcast.
Fourth-generation owners, Lauren Crosby.
I'm making a mental note never to miss a podcast ever again.
And Leah Cook.
I was listening, were you?
Director of Attractions, Eric Rentz.
I want it to be borderline obnoxious.
And Director of Communications, Paula Wernie.
No more funnel cakes for you. You're getting hopped up on sugar.
Now stow your loose articles, buckle up,
and please keep your hands and legs inside the car at all times.
And we are back. This is the official Holiday World podcast, podcast episode 032. Now, there must be reaction to that. We react to the
that
number.
That was the number of the school bus I rode when I was in elementary school.
Oh,
just 32, not 032.
Very cool. And today is Thursday, April 27th, 2017. And this episode is the one with the hanging Chad.
Yes.
Because we have Chad Benefiel from WBKR Radio here with us today.
Thanks for having me. I'm very excited to be part of this.
And he's got the best voice.
Yeah.
So the rest of us are going to be like, hey, hey. But we've already had that discussion. We all hate our voices. And now
quit talking now.
And let's just let Chad do all
that. He could do a good Matt impression.
Yeah, better than you, because you sound like Droopy Dog whenever you try to impersonate me.
I didn't tell Chad ahead of time how much we argue on this podcast.
Where we get it all out.
We do. We get it all out, and it's 2 days before opening day, so there's a lot to be
stressed about.
Spewed. I don't know if we want to use that particular
word. We're actually
looking
really good. I feel better this year than we have in a long time in terms of being prepared, so park looks great. Park looks
just really, really good. And Chad, for those of you who have followed our history for the last several years, he was the funny guy, the MC, on Christmas Eve in July when we announced Thunderbird back in 2014. You remember that, Chad?
Yes, I remember. It was an absolute blast. The crowd was great. Of course, the big reveal of the ride was amazing.
Because you didn't know, right?
Yeah, I had no clue.
You didn't know.
He was like a kid in a toy store.
I was. And it was funny because I was asking people in the crowd if they had any idea. And I literally had no idea. So when I was asking them, I was really looking for answers. And I love the one gal. I said, so Holiday World is spending like 20-something million dollars on this brand new ride. What do you think it's going to be? And she said, well, I see dirt. Okay, they did not spend $26 million on dirt, Princess.
Oh, my.
It was incredible, though. I loved it. And, of course, the Thunderbird is amazing.
Now, you didn't always love thrill rides, did you, Chad?
You know, I didn't. In fact, I was trying to think about the very first time I came to this park. And I'm pretty sure, if memory serves me correctly, that my grandparents brought me. And I think I was about 8 years old. Of course, it was Santa Claus Land at the time.
Right.
And this is like mid-70s. I'm going to date myself a little bit. But yeah, I wasn't a big thrill ride seeker. I mean, it took a lot. I remember going to parks as a kid, and my younger sister loved roller coasters, but I would not get on them. Times have changed.
Of course, we had so many roller coasters back in our Santa Claus.
Well, there was one.
Yes, there was.
What was it called?
Was it called fire?
The firecracker.
The firecracker.
Called the firecracker. Yes.
You've ridden firecracker so many years.
Circle.
I have. And firecracker, I remember it very well because it would leave the docking station and roll out, and you would do like a quick right turn and then go up the hill. And I could hear the chain. And
right.
I remember being on that for the first time thinking, oh my gosh. Of course, as a kid.
It's so high.
It seems so high, right? I mean, now in retrospect, you get on the Voyage and that's high.
Yeah, that is high.
But the firecracker, yeah, I remember riding that for the first time. And I remember coming to a stop. The brakes were just brutal.
They were hand brakes.
They were.
Yes, I'm sure a lot of our listeners know exactly what we're talking about.
Former employees loved it a lot too.
Yes.
I think that's the first like roller coaster I ever rode as a kid. So,
what was your favorite ride back then?
What was my favorite ride? I was a big fan of the Thunder Bumpers on Chesapeake Bay. Is that right?
Right. With
I love
lighthouse.
Those.
All boats, please stop.
Which is where firecracker is right now.
Right. Yep.
Exactly. Yeah.
So we've come full circle.
Yeah, that was really, really fun. I mean, I'm not sure what it was about the appeal of that, but something about like being able to drive, you know, like the first opportunity to drive a vehicle. It wasn't really a vehicle. It was like a donut that had a motor on the back.
To you, it was
had to be
a
and act aggressively.
And you
could bump and make a little splash. Yeah,
it's like bumper cars on the water. That was ingenious.
That's cool.
Right. And as you said to me earlier, that it had a unique scent.
Well, I mean, I enjoy any ride where you can actually like get off and smell like gasoline. It's like, yes.
Which of course, then you could also light up a cigarette and off you go. You know, that was before the no smoking took over everywhere. But,
Good times. A lot of time I spent at this park when I was a kid. And I remember coming here in high school with friends. We would skip out of school and come to the park like in May. That was fun. And
thank you for your business.
The listeners, you would never do that.
No.
Because Matt's on the school board, so he has to say that.
I am.
He has to say that. Way to represent, Matt.
So he can stay on the school board.
That's not something I ever did, ever.
So we invited Chad to join us. Was it last fall when we came down to the studio? And I think, or may have been a whole year ago.
Yeah, you've been a few times, actually.
Yeah. So we've been waiting. Thought it would be fun to have Chad come up right before we open. And so here we are. And he's going to sit in. He even brought noisemakers. He's going to join us for 33 degrees of separation.
It's so much fun. You're going to love it.
Well, I would like to just say to in advance that my noisemaker does have some Latin flair. So get ready for it.
Nice.
It's Calypso ride. You know, he's theming. Okay. He's all about
it. Is it really Calypso?
You're going to give him points just for that, aren't you?
I think I shall.
Yeah.
So, and he also brought two noisemakers. So he's got a backup, which I'm also very impressed with. Because we've had some noisemakers.
You're making us look bad, Chad.
I have an app, though, with like 43 different sounds.
We've also had some failures over the many episodes, over the 32 episodes, where Rentz's app won't stop playing the... Yes, it's true.
Sorry.
He used to actually bring, since he's over rides, all attractions, so rides and the water park, so he brought a lifeguard whistle, which was so very clever.
Makes sense.
Then he didn't always remember.
Well, I would get complaints. Oh, it was really loud that time. So I figured the consistency of an app would be better for your ears.
And the kindness of your heart.
Yes.
You brought that.
I did it for you.
But it goes on forever.
It does.
It's just like, okay, we're ready. Which gives him extra time to think of an answer.
Yeah, it's all strategic.
We're all very,
So get ready, Chad.
Very
intense.
We're going to move into our first segment, which is called Amusings. And the first topic is a little bit sad. Over the weekend, we saw the very sad news of Aaron Moran passing away. And Matt and I have this sick game we play of who can find out someone famous died first and tell the other. Because that we
do. You typically win.
That is a sick game.
Why is that a game?
I don't know.
Do you have to buzz in first?
It's kind of I texted him first. And then he's like, oh no! Because you loved Happy Days.
I did. I loved Happy Days.
And
I loved Joni and Chachi.
Well, then Joni loves Chachi. That was a spinoff.
Yeah. Not anymore.
Not anymore.
Yeah, right. Chachi, bad boy.
I wonder if they still kept in touch.
Oh, I saw his statement.
I don't think so.
He had a statement?
Yeah, and it wasn't.
Yeah.
You have to look.
But in case anyone hasn't been watching pop culture news, I guess we could call it, Aaron Moran actually lived right outside of Corydon, which is, 3 miles from the park or so?
Yes.
And she made in the news kind of an unfortunate story back in 2012, and we all went, what? Joni's in Corydon? It was just one of those.
I'm just hearing this. Really?
Yes.
Crazy.
Yeah. Her second husband's mom was from Corydon, was sick, and so they moved back to Corydon to help take care of her.
She's just been there the whole time.
Yes, they were there the whole time.
I had no clue. And I stop off at that Wendy's every time I go to Louisville.
Yeah. She might have
seen
there.
Joni at Wendy's.
You should have.
Yes.
And speaking of Wendy's, which has great chicken sandwiches, here's Justin.
Great segue.
Well, it's food.
His timing is amazing.
It's
like we summoned him.
What is Justin bringing
are those
us?
Healthy and options?
Thank you, Justin. I know we're asking a lot of you right before we open that you would cook for us.
I would
Does
love
anybody
some, yes.
need water? And Justin is also, I'll have to give you a shout out for getting up very early tomorrow morning because we have some TV news crews coming in.
Where's my shout out?
Before dawn. Well, that's your job.
With the rest of us.
Okay, I've just met Justin, but he's not my favorite person this week because he brought dessert first.
We got a couple new ones this year. We got chewy praline, which is new.
Praline?
Cookie dough, which is new, and then maple walnut, which is new.
Ooh, fudge.
What are the other ones?
They're ones we've had.
Birthday cake, Oreo, and sea salt.
You have to
caramel.
Eat your sandwich first, Eric.
Okay.
I'll save the fudge.
I see salads.
Till the end. Look on his face. He's like, what, eight?
I didn't know what people wanted.
You.
So I got salad, and I got sandwiches.
Wow, okay, man, you went great. To town.
Seriously.
Holy heck, that's crazy.
Great, Caesar salads. I would love a Caesar salad.
Have you been doing this all morning?
That is a hearty helping of chicken.
It is. It's like a full chicken breast.
Yeah, he's Justin and his team have recreated the salads for this year.
I want to know who sent the text about that chicken. Was it you, Paul, or Matt? Who alerted the other one the chicken was gone?
What chicken?
What?
Oh, well, okay.
Where? What?
What? Never mind.
I missed it.
Yeah, your game.
Ooh, oh, that chicken died a long time ago.
Oh, man.
Oh.
Okay, cheese curds.
Chicken that died.
I know that cheese curds is Matt's favorite food in the word. Next.
That was what
he talking about?
Southwest
pet?
Chicken sandwich? Okay.
What?
His pet chicken?
I never had a pet chicken.
He had a pet skunk.
I had a pet skunk.
You had a pet skunk?
I did.
He had a pet. It didn't
end
well.
That's why I thought you were saying the chicken.
There's a sad story. We'll talk later.
Don't ask about it. It gets brought up later with some of our feedback. So did you bring us different burgers?
They're all the same.
Okay, that's fine.
Fries. So we have a Southwest chicken sandwich fries.
So, Lauren, what are you able to eat? Let's let you get first pick.
Just put them down. We'll see what we normally do. Just go in.
Okay, and everybody just... Everybody will just dig
in. I'll still probably just take a
here, do you want?
Little bite of everything.
Do you here, take one.
Don't knock what over a microphone. All right. Well, thank you so much. Lots of great specialty burgers this year.
Thank you for coming in early to the podcast.
Yes.
So we have to wait until it's almost over. Yeah. Now there's something to do
during the podcast.
Yeah, because, you know, talking, that's not something.
Just talking to each other.
Yes.
Cheese curds.
One more cheese curds.
Just pop it down. We'll take care of it.
We'll find a way to consume. We can put the fudge on the shelf there.
Don't take that fudge away. What are you talking about? Justin, get out while you're ahead.
Yeah. Chad puts it
very
well.
Problem.
We've talked a lot about how we need to have more, like a bigger table.
Yeah, this table's
a banquet table.
This table's not cutting it.
What are you bringing to the next podcast?
All right. Let's get back to being sad about Erin Moran.
Yeah.
How about
it? And she did pass away over the... Anybody else a big... Oh, I've lost. So everyone's concentration is gone.
So as we were talking about it, one of my friends posted a picture of himself and her together. He was her doctor in Corden.
Really?
A guy I graduated with in high school, he was her doctor in Corden.
Because Matt is 2 degrees of separation from everyone on the planet.
So I do apologize. She's like, of course you know somebody that knows her.
Of course you know them. And you were college roommates with at least 500 people, which brings up a whole other list of questions.
Say, how long were you
He's
in college?
Told me so four many
people.
Stories
four people.
About, oh, yeah, well, he was my roommate. And same with your wife, Tanya. Oh, yeah, she's married to blah, blah, blah. And it just...
We just room with very colorful people.
You are from
people.
The tiniest county. Crawford County, Indiana, is as big as a thimble. And you know everybody.
And we love you, Wolfpack, just so you know.
Oh, my.
Wolfpack. Were you part of the Wolfpack?
I was.
What sport
did
you
play? I'd howl right now, but no.
Oh, thank you. You'd howl cheese curds all over the rest of us. And so this actually ties in loosely with another story about Corydon being in national news lately, which was the whole Brad's wife thing with Cracker Barrel.
That's right,
Cracker
Barrel.
Oh, that was in Corydon?
That was
yes.
Oh, my gosh. That was in Corydon.
You sent me your something about Brad's wife, and I was
welcome
like, I don't know what
2016.
I guess.
I sent the email out, to our staff of directors just as an example of how things can go crazy on Facebook and that sort of thing. And what do I hear? I get a phone call. It's Matt Eckert. And what does he say? I know you won't believe me, but
I know Brad's wife
and Brad.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you were.
He knows
that.
Brad and Brad's wife.
But Corydon, they're having a rough one.
Yeah.
But
they lived in Crawford County. She just worked in Corydon, but they went to my high school.
So maybe when she did work at Cracker Barrel, maybe she waited on Joni on Erin
Probably.
Moran. So rest in peace, Erin Moran. So we wanted to talk a little bit about how Chad came up a half hour early before we were scheduled to start the podcast to ride Firecracker.
The new Firecracker.
The new Firecracker.
The new and improved.
Yeah, I don't know if you would have come up to ride the old ones.
Oh, I totally would have.
A little scared little guy. But it was great because we were also able to invite the rest of our full-time staff to come enjoy it with you. And that was really fun.
Yeah, Matt, you said it was the inaugural ride today, right?
For everyone to ride a full cycle, yeah.
Yeah, there have been some tests with some individuals. I know your brother William, Lauren's brother William, rode.
So that was my first time.
Only like two or three people. That was the first full load.
Yeah.
So we learned something on this ride because it is a family ride. And the cars on it are perfect for, you know, like an adult and then a child to sit with them. Well, Matt and I decided we would ride together.
Because this is on Facebook Live, yes. So we wanted them together.
So we rode in the same car, and we were kind of cozy. We were kind of afraid we were going to need a crowbar.
You guys were wedged in there.
We basically were,
it took you a little while to settle in. It was very entertaining, and you're certainly not wide-hipped gentlemen, but that does give you
wide-hipped gentlemen. Thank you, Paula.
I could think of another way to say it, but we'd have to edit it out.
It was a fun ride, though.
It was. Yeah, I really enjoyed it.
And Eric, weren't you saying that the ride has like different? He's eating.
I'm sorry.
Sorry, Eric and I are having a moment with the cheese curds. they're like a little spicy. They're really good.
So, what speed were we traveling at today?
I think we were on an 8.
On
an 8, yep. We had increased it a little bit, and we feel it's a really good speed now, so. But yeah.
But really, you don't find out until you get riders on
it,
do you?
Yeah, right. You get feedback, and it rides a lot different. I don't know if you guys felt the same way. It rides a lot different than it looks.
It does, yeah.
It feels faster when you're on it.
Oh, good.
It feels faster than 8 miles an hour.
Well, yeah.
8 miles an hour? That's not what it is. That's 8 RPM. Is that what
I was going to say?
No, that's revolutions per minute.
Is that
hour?
I didn't mean miles per hour. I meant 8. I was thinking miles per hour. Okay. I meant 8. It feels faster than that, though.
Yeah.
Than an 8. So we'll have to see for Hollywood Nights. Are you going to come to Hollywood Nights, Chad?
I would love to. And that's
all right.
I told him when it was.
That's June 2nd and 3rd.
Oh, yes. I'm here.
And you know how we always theme around a movie? So this year's movie theme is Jurassic Park.
I think that's great.
So we're going to have fun with that. And
we're pumped.
We'll definitely have to get some great rides on Firecracker. And the sign, the backdrop sign, is beautiful. It's all lit up. Mm-hmm. So you can go to our Facebook page and see. We did record the first big ride. We recorded it live this morning. So
we should have a podcast viewing party of all the movies.
That would be fun. Of all the movies from all the years?
All the Jurassic Park. Movies, Jurassic Park.
Okay. I think it's probably too late, isn't it?
What do you mean it's too late? Year.
Because the theming's done, right?
No, I mean, we should just all watch it
just
we're
for
friends.
Fun. Just to get in the mood.
I'm still adding some little touches.
Okay. All right. Do you want to plan it at your house?
Sure.
You never had that housewarming you were going to have.
I know. Well, it's still being worked on.
Yeah. Are you going to bake that pie for us?
Are you going to have cheese curds and fudge there?
Yeah. Well,
spicy cheese curds.
I won't say yes because I'll under.
He still owes us a pumpkin pie.
I made you a pie. Don't forget.
Not a pumpkin pie.
You're so ungrateful.
He did make a really good pie. He'd never made a pie in his life, but he promised us he would, and it took months and months and months.
But that would be fun.
It was good.
It was good.
Quite good.
I gave him props.
Technically,
I don't care what Matt says. I think it's so good.
I gave him props. It was a good pie, but it wasn't
what he
promised.
I think that fulfills his promise.
It doesn't.
Thank you.
I think so.
You can come to the viewing party.
Thank you.
I have all the movies at home, so I don't need to come.
You can come to the viewing party. You can come too, Matt.
But
you have to sit in the corner.
By myself.
The last episode, we talked about the Red Book magazine had made a video of one of our past high divers, Cecily Carlton. And it kind of went all over the place on Facebook, and it was really exciting. And some people recognized her as having been a diver here. And Lauren has some wonderful news.
Yes, I'm very excited to say that Cecily is coming back this summer.
Awesome.
Cecily and her husband.
And her husband. That's great. And she is the world's number one.
Oh, don't ask
high
me.
Diver. She has several titles.
She's won several titles. She goes and does the Red Bull Cliff diving competitions, and she I think places every time she competes, so she's pretty amazing.
But here's the crazy thing about Cecily: she's a high diver, but she was afraid of heights.
Well, I guess that's a good way to get over it, right?
Challenge yourself, yeah,
right.
But she's still afraid of heights, right?
Yeah,
she has to overcome every single day.
So your highest dive at the show is how far from the pool?
You had to ask me.
It was 80 feet in the past. Is that what it still is?
But that's,
I was going to say 70 or 80.
Yeah.
That's really high up. I mean, especially if you're sitting there in the stands and looking up. I mean, it looks daunting.
Remember years ago.
Oh, I would never climb that.
We had an interview with a TV station years ago, and one of the high divers, they said, what does it look like from up there? Because now you could send a GoPro up on their head or something like that. And they said, when you get up to the top and you look down, it looks like, they said, go home and put a little cup of water on the floor and climb up on your countertop and look down. You feel like you're going to dive into that cup of water.
That's really cool.
He said it, but climbing straight up 8 stories, you don't want to have to climb down 8 stories. So you'd rather dive than have to climb down.
Yeah, I would never climb up there in the first place.
No.
So hats off.
That's
how the divers get into the new dives and stuff like that as they have the new people climb up. And then by the time they climb up to like whatever perch they're on, it's generally higher than what they've been before. By the time they're up there, they're like, I am not climbing down. So the only other option is to jump.
Mm. Remember when Bert the Conqueror was here?
Oh my gosh.
And he did a little bit with the high dive where they taught him how to dive. And
he was just going off one of the diving boards, right?
Did he actually go off the board? I think he just jumped in the pool in the end. Because remember he started it and he goes, ow, it hurts my feet. He did a belly flop.
Yeah,
he was delightful.
It was something.
And then he went and kind of, wearing a Speedo. Yes. And kind of went out into the walkway.
Kind of paraded.
Yeah. Yeah. And we have a great picture of Lauren and Leah with him.
There was a lot of shouting.
Forbid me to use. But yeah, people recognize old Bert Kreischer. He's a heck of a guy. We are up for two very interesting USA Today polls. And we need Woo-hoo. Your votes, please. The USA Today does, they're a month long, so it's quite the commitment to go and vote every day, but we're encouraging people to do so. They put up just the other day, that's right. Say it again, Lauren.
You gotta be in it to win it.
That's right. And one of them is best amusement park, and the other is best outdoor water park. So there's lots of great, they very carefully chosen the contenders, and we're very proud to be among the contenders in both of these polls. And so we'll put this, we always do a blog post about each podcast episode, and we will put the links there, and we certainly appreciate your votes.
So is voting open now, or is it open?
It is open. It opened on Monday.
And you vote once a day.
And we shared the link on our Facebook.
Yes.
So I'm sure you'll
share it
again.
We'll share it again. Yeah. Yes. So for both polls, and you can tell what the score is at this point.
Good time right away. Holiday World is this.
Yes.
One vote per day per browser.
Yes. Yes, per browser and per device.
It's been kind of like...
Yeah. You can tell who's posting something on their Facebook page, because all of a sudden, this early on, then they'll be number one for a little bit until somebody goes, hey, and then another park will post it, and then
so
they'll be number one.
Hey!
Yes, so please vote for...
Why not a radio station that may help spread the word?
Yeah.
That would be
take
awesome.
That, other contenders.
Exactly. You don't have a Chad.
We've got USA Chad.
You don't have a Chad.
That's right.
Oh, man.
We'd also like to talk about our buddy Mick Foley, the wrestler. Are you familiar with him?
Sure, of course.
And he was our other star who was on the podcast, last fall, I believe. Yeah. He was in town. Mm-hmm. And came on and told some great stories. He just had hip surgery.
Yep. He did?
And it went well, yes, earlier in the week. And so we say hip, hip, hooray.
There was a documentary about him, right?
Probably.
I know about him being Santa. I know he was behind a documentary about the wearing the red suit. Because he's really gotten into that since he's
I feel like there was one of those VH1 shows. Yeah, I feel like I've seen something about him.
He just got some kind of big promotion recently, too. Like, he's like general manager.
No,
of...
he actually just got fired from that.
Yeah,
because of the hip surgery.
Yeah, so how do you fire somebody
and
get away with
it? It was firing in terms of like the theatrics of the show. Not that it's all theater, because Mick Foley told us it's very real.
Yeah, I mean, the stories he told, that was real.
But like, I'm sure his part as the general manager is a little, I don't know. But he was at least theatrically fired.
Really?
Yes. Because he had to have hip surgery.
I'm sure they didn't say that's why they fired him, though, did they? In the theatrics of it? Or?
I have no idea. I didn't see it. I just know that he was fired. And I was like, oh,
yeah,
that's
I saw
sad.
It, too. I saw the news.
I was like, dude, you got a lawsuit if that's the case.
Well, yeah. I think there were news articles. I don't know if it was said in his firing, but in news articles, it was definitely said that because he was having hip surgery. Because my husband knew.
Because
my husband told me.
Yeah.
Okay. And that's how
I
knew.
Now I'm going to have to Google it and look it up.
Yeah. Well, shout out to Mick. And we tweeted to him and said we can't wait to see him again, because he's got a book coming out this fall about kind of his memoir of being wearing the red suit and being Santa Claus. And he went to different locations around the country that are Christmas year round and wrote. So he wrote from our Santa chair in Kringle's or the Mrs. Claus's kitchen. So he sat in the big green chair and he wrote some of his book in there. So that was neat. He's a great guy. Now, speaking of surgical routines, it reminded me, wasn't there someone who was supposed to get a tattoo before the start of the season?
Yes. Hey, we open in 2 days.
Does that qualify as surgery?
It feels like it sometimes, as somebody who has lots of tattoos, I can tell you. Depends on where you get it, but it can feel like surgery.
But the key was before we opened.
And let's
the
give
water
Chad,
park.
Let's give Chad the backstory so he knows what we're talking about and why we're bugging Eric yet again.
Matt, do you want to
take the story?
So the whole thing was...
I'm just going to have a cheese curd while you're talking.
We have an outside group called Ellison Associates that comes in and performs audits of our water park and our lifeguards. We have statistically done extremely, extremely well. So Eric here said that
Perfect scores.
So Eric here said that if we once again repeated this, he would get a tattoo to commemorate the award.
So what is the tattoo going to be?
It's going to be a, and we might have posted it on one of the...
We have not. You haven't released the design yet.
It's because we're I've shown a ton of people.
Because it's not convinced you're actually going to do it, so we don't want to get people's hopes up.
And let them down. You don't want to disappoint
them. We know how that is.
It's a roller coaster hill, and then it's got a wave, so it's like the rides in the water park together. It's really cool. It's good. I haven't scheduled an appointment, but the water park doesn't open until...
May 11th. I'm glad you're on top of that.
Yeah, believe me, I know it's coming. We're getting ready.
Yes.
But I couldn't remember 10th or 11th.
Two weeks.
So from today. Listen.
2 weeks.
Listen. It's going to get done. A couple people that were in doing work crew for us from the water park were asking me about it. It's on my list.
What list?
I think we have a podcast on May 12th, don't we?
Oh, it's a bad day for a podcast.
Which would be the day after your 2 week.
A school day operation.
Yeah, we'll have to probably move that one.
The point is, the next podcast is going to be somewhere around your due date.
The reveal.
Okay.
So where are you going to have this?
It's going to be my left left leg, somewhere on my leg. But I have to, you know, we can't have visible tattoos, so I have to get it in an appropriate place.
Right.
Or, I mean, I can cover it, but...
That's no fun.
Somebody wanted him to shave his head and have it on his head.
Oh, because
then his hair would grow back.
Yeah, it's okay.
Too late now.
There are all sorts of ideas.
Would it grow back if you had a tattoo there?
It does, but you know, Kelly Osbourne has a tattoo on her head.
But it's like shaved, right?
Yeah, you can see it if her head's shaved.
Okay.
But like she can let it grow out, right? Yeah. It'll come in. It won't come in like that pattern, right? Like the hair will
grow. You
won't
have a roller coaster going out of your head.
That would be kind of cool.
That would be kind of fun, yeah.
You need to rethink this whole thing, Eric.
No, I do want to do it, and I'm excited. And it was a bet, and a bet's a bet, and our team worked really hard, and I just got to go through the humiliation.
I don't know how many water parks Ellis works with, but they're worldwide, and they're just the preeminent lifeguard training program out there. And we checked when... We knew we were in the top 10% because we had platinum. Is that right?
We had platinum. Yes. Top 10% is platinum.
But we wanted to know how many of these top 10% get perfect scores, because perfect score is amazing. Perfect. So it's the top 6%.
Top 6%, right.
So that was, and that's amazing that the lifeguards and flight attendants and everyone, because it's all about safety, bottom line. We can sit here and chuckle all we want, but it's all about keeping folks safe while they're having fun in the water. So Mr. Rantz.
It's the team. We just had another lifeguard training this past weekend, and it reminds you, you know, that Jennifer and Kayla, they do such a great job with all their management, and it reminds you why they do so well.
And is it 32 hours of training before we open?
Lifeguards get a whole weekend. And then slide attendants this year do the same thing. They just do them on different weekends. So they get a full weekend, but it's long days. They're in the pool. They're out of the pool. They do CPR training. And then, of course, their training never ends. They do training again before we open, and then it's ongoing. They have to complete in-service hours. So it's extensive. You know, it's a lot, but it's really important. So.
It's a lot of free sunscreen.
Well, bravo. Do it again this year. Get another tattoo. Are you going to make that promise again?
Yeah,
I'm going to get this tattoo, and then we'll figure out something else for this year.
Matching one on the other leg.
I don't know. We'll see.
He could do like Jekyll and Hyde tattoos. Get like the old firecracker and the new firecracker side by side.
I like the firecracker thing. Yeah. Yeah. That's kind of cool. We'll figure something else. Maybe I'll like get my nose pierced or something.
No.
No.
That's funny, right? No. I mean, I would never do it, but...
But he says it anyway.
We'll talk. Right. You know what, listeners? Send in your thoughts.
Yes.
There you go.
Use
what kind of humiliation would you like to say? Well, Matt's going to do it this year, so remember.
Oh, make sure and pass
that along.
I don't
commit to things like that.
If you are on Facebook, you've probably noticed that we have a really fun contest going on right now called Quickly. And it's a company we've worked with, Quickly without a C. I've had a real hard time typing the word with a missing letter in it, but I think I finally... don't have to go back and edit everything that I sent out. But Quickly is a program. Have you all done this before? Have you done any of these?
No.
It's something very different. We do a lot of sweepstakes at the park, but this is something where I'm just going to I wrote it out because I thought I don't think I could ever explain it just off the top of my head. But we are launching our 71st season with a huge giveaway, and it's a promotion called Quickly, where it's all about who is the quickest to respond when the contest starts, and it starts at an unknown time.
Dun dun dun!
It could be any minute.
The quickest to respond with like right information, like you have to answer a question. Or?
No, all you have to do basically what we're asking people to do this week is to opt in. So look on our Facebook page. We'll also, it's on the blog. And you click on the link to go opt in. And when you opt in, you can also share. Say, I've opt in. Hey, 10 of my friends. We all have 10 friends, right?
I do.
All with.
Chad knows everyone, remember?
He went to college
with 10 friends.
Can you loan some to Renz?
I did. Just since you asked that, I already did it 10 times.
And so you can go ahead and loan a few friends out.
I'll share
out
some
to,
friends with you.
Oh, thanks. I wasn't sure what I was going to do.
He always says Eric only has one friend. He's very unkind.
But I stole him.
It's not him.
and then they can share, and you know, you do the whole viral
thing.
The
more shares you get, like it gives you more of an advantage.
Right.
Well, an advantage. You get to know prior to like this.
So your chance to win is better.
Your chance, yes.
Right.
You will get an early notification that the contest is about to start.
Gotcha.
So say, and this is not the time that it is, but say it was noon on Sunday, you could earn up to, I think, an hour and a half notice.
Really?
That you sign it up as either as a text or as an email that you'll get notification, and it will tell you exactly the time that you will then receive the link. And the Quickly part of it is when you get the link at that time that nobody knows except for four of us, is you want to click on the link, and whoever clicks in first wins. What do they win? Their prize package is 4 2-day tickets to Holiday World and Splash and Safari, and 2 nights at a Holiday Cottage next door at Lake Rudolph Campground. So it's a great weekend getaway, or during the week getaway, a family vacation package. And then the next 25 quickest people will win a pair of tickets.
Oh, wow.
And then
everybody gets a
promo code. So the quickest 26 people will get tickets.
Right.
And so those people can respond like through their phones or like a computer or?
Right. Right. It'll be through a text or through an email.
They just click a link or they have to write something?
All they do is click a link.
Wow. And so what does everyone else get?
And everybody gets a promo code.
There you go.
So everybody's a winner.
Everybody's a winner.
Hey. Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Everyone gets a trophy.
And it's just, and people are.
A medal, they're better.
And then people are all, you know, posting, pick me, and it's like, no, it's not.
That's not how it works.
How often are we doing Quickly?
This is the first time we've ever done it.
But like, how many times will we repeat the contest?
This is a one-time thing.
Oh, just okay, gotcha.
As far as I know, I don't know.
Yeah, because 25 second place ticket winners, I mean, that's big.
It's a big deal.
Yeah, it's a big deal.
Yeah. So it's been a lot of fun, and a lot of people are entering, and we hope, I can tell you as of now, that the time that the contest starts will not be during this podcast recording, so it won't happen now, but by the time you listen to this podcast, the time might be very close, or depending when you listen, it might be afterwards.
So,
but it is, we can say it is coming up very soon.
We didn't even have to sign up for that hint. Look at
that.
Isn't
that great?
We know it's
coming.
That's
intel right
there. I'm
going to
delay the podcast airing so I can get an advantage.
Sorry, employees of Holiday World and Splash and Safari are not eligible to win. Never wins anything. You won perfect scores.
You want a tattoo.
Oh, that's true. Yes. I want a tattoo.
Yes. Cheese curds.
And I win bi-weekly humiliation.
Who sounds like Droopy Dog now?
Cheese curds. Oh,
they're spicy.
Country music being from WBKR,
yes, ma'am.
I do have to tell you one time, I don't know why we were talking about Hee Haw. Matt was talking about his parents, and we talked about Minnie Pearl, and he said, what was that tea bag hanging from her hat? He thought that was a tea bag.
Wait, what was it? Just a price tag?
To be fair, I was probably like 5 when I watched it with my parents.
I will never get over that, because he was so serious. And what was the thing with that tea bag?
It looked like a tea bag.
It's hilarious.
And come to think of it, it really did, but it was still
She probably wore one every now and then just for a kick
of
bag.
Oh, what kind of tea?
Lipton, of course.
Lipton.
Oh, yes. Yes, of course. We are Holiday World, and we love holidays.
Yes, we do.
Did did you know that, Chad? And April 29th, coming up very soon, not only is it opening day, it is International Dance Day. Mm. Woo. Who likes to dance at this table?
I like to dance.
Me too.
What kind of dancing is your favorite, Lauren? Because you know a lot of different dancing stuff.
A fair amount.
Are you a line dancer, Lauren? Am I hearing like a cha-cha slide from you? Are you doing the wobble? What are you doing?
The wobble. Do the wobble.
On a daily basis.
She's done ballet.
I took ballet, tap, and jazz, and hip-hop are the main.
Because she steps in our shows when we have somebody who's sick.
I was just recently in our Halloween show. 3 different days.
It's so much fun.
Watch. Halloween is what, 12 days? And I was in the show 3 of those days.
The show must go on. So what's do you have a favorite dance move or a favorite type of dance?
I don't know. I mean, ballet always has my heart. It's what I started with.
How about you, Chad? You like to dance?
Yeah, actually. I choreographed professionally for like 20 years.
Oh, cool.
Wow.
And I didn't know that.
Yeah, so you learned something today.
What?
Presumably step in on our shows if we have a guy.
So if we have a guy on Halloween, you're there.
So if you go to YouTube and you type in my name and you type in single ladies.
No.
You will
this
see.
This is going to make the blog.
You know it's going to be a link that we're going to send out.
Right? You will see a video of me performing the entire Beyonce video. Step by step.
Wow.
And laying it out, I must say.
We will find that. Wow. We'll put that on the blog post.
A few years back for the Lanham Brothers Jamboree, they asked me to come and be a special guest, and I said, sure. And they're like, what do you want to do? I was like, I think I'm going to recreate Beyonce's Single Ladies video. It's hilarious.
And they're like, okay.
Because that's totally what I would do.
In my spare time. Right. Yeah.
I've always thought we should do, because we always do a little, well, don't always, but sometimes do a little entertaining during Hollywood nights that I rewrote the words to Single Ladies.
Oh, that's funny.
All the coaster lovers, put your hands up. Up, you know, it fits.
Oh, nice.
It really does.
So maybe we can get together.
Chad can come out here in the background.
Get up and,
like, our guest choreographer.
We need to.
Leah and I could probably join him because.
Yes.
In the video,
I learned the dance in my hip hop class and then I taught it to my sister.
All right, lock it in. Lock
and
in
we
the
also
dates.
Had that in the show 1 year. Too that Leah was in the
show. Is
shows.
It hard?
Oh,
dance?
But they didn't do the real dance.
No, they didn't. But
it just looks like a lot of bending.
it's pretty intense. There's some there's some parts of it that you're like, oh. Yeah.
That's not the sound we would make.
Lauren's like, I'm glad I'm not single anymore.
Remember the evolution of dance? Remember that popular video? I recreated that one time too.
Cool.
That's on YouTube as well.
See, you never know what you'll learn on the official Holiday World podcast.
What we just learned is we need to Google everybody in here just to see what they've done.
What have you done? And we can't move on from talking about dance without mentioning Will's happy dance. Matt, you can explain what that all entails.
You really can't explain it. It was something that's hard to explain in words. But anytime something that would make him happy, he did his little happy dance. It was kind of like jumping around and just acting goofy.
Do you remember an example of what made him happy?
It was never anything in particular. It was always something kind of off the wall that you wouldn't think would be something that would make him happy.
He just leaped to his feet.
Well, I mean, the day we hit 1 million guests.
Yeah,
that was a happy dance.
I think we
day.
All did a happy dance that day. But yeah, that was a happy dance day.
I remember the day like my dad was
came
like,
across
my dad
the radio.
Was like, he was like, call your friends, get them to come and just swipe their
close,
season
we're
pass.
Close. What year was that?
2006.
Was it like at the end of the year?
Voyage.
No, it was like, mid-season. It was probably like July, July, early August.
Yeah.
It's very cool.
That was an exciting, exciting day. Another great day is May 4th, Star Wars Day.
Mm. Yep. May the 4th be with you.
And we always pull out the picture of Will holding his, what is that bank?
The Darth Vader bobblehead bank.
Bobblehead talking bank.
Yes.
That I got him that he kept on his desk. I was so pleased with. But he turned it off so it wouldn't.
I am your
banker. You walked in.
I am your banker.
Are you a Star Wars fan? Star Wars or Star Trek? Do you have
goodness. I was never a Star Trek fan growing up. But honestly, I wasn't a Star Wars fan really growing up either. But like the reboots of both franchises, I'm on board with. In fact, I love what J.J. Abrams has done with Star Trek. It's awesome. And we get the new Star Wars film, I think, right before Christmas this year. Is it in December? Oh. Looking forward to that.
Yeah.
May 5th is Hug a Shed and Take a Selfie Day. Those aren't two separate holidays. It's Hug a Shed and Take a Selfie.
Shed.
Like a shed. S-H-E-D.
Like in your backyard.
Like with tools in it?
Right.
What if you don't have a shed?
It's for gardeners who love their sheds.
Originally
for Thunderbird, they wanted to call what we call the barn a shed. So I thought maybe on May 5th that maybe, Eric, you could go down and hug the barn. And
take a selfie
hugging the barn.
Hugging the barn, because it's also May 5th. It's No Pants Day.
Oh. Otherwise known as Eric Rince Day.
That's right.
I've already filled Chad in on that.
Okay, guys, we're going to have to relive that again.
I had like 10 minutes to prep them while we're walking down.
This podcast has been on for over a year. Are we repeating holidays at all?
Well, No Pants Day will come up every year.
It works its way into all different kinds of conversations. Paul and I were talking yesterday. She's like, I got to get off here soon. I have a Skype interview. I said, make sure you have your pants on.
No worries about that.
Yeah. And you're a verb. I said, don't Eric rinse it.
Don't rinse it.
Oh, don't worry about that. May 11th, two holidays that I think are very interesting in how they balance each other out. Eat What You Want Day.
Wait,
okay.
And Root Canal Appreciation Day.
Oh.
Root Canal Appreciation Day.
Is that a thing?
Yes. I do not make these things up.
Who would appreciate a root canal besides your dentist?
I guess it
makes $1,200.
Well, right. Maybe it's the Dentist Association's holiday, and then they can go hug their shed and take a selfie.
Well, don't be hugging me on that.
Well, those 2 days sort of go hand in hand. I mean, one thing leads to the next, right?
Exactly.
Eat what you want, then you're going to have a root canal. So,
want some fudge, Chad?
I would actually love some. Yeah, please.
Get ready for May 11th.
Dig right in. It is time for Ho-Wo-Po feedback.
Yay.
That is our hashtag that we use for our podcast, a Ho-Wo for Holiday World and Po for podcasting.
Love it.
And it works most of the time. We heard from Bob Green on Twitter, which is at Bob05. And he said, Holiday World, I am from Lima, Ohio. It's pronounced Lima, right? Or Lima.
Lima.
Is it Lima, Ohio?
I think it's Lima.
And our town mascot is a giant lima bean.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, yeah, because the holiday was
Lima Bean Appreciation Day.
Oh, my gosh.
And so,
not just eat your lima bean day.
We have many mascots at our park, but
we sure do.
Did you ever think to create a lima bean?
No.
And his name is Beanie. So we'll put this on the blog post.
Well, what else would you name him?
I guess.
Lima?
I think Beanie's a great
name. That's dumb, Eric.
Fred. Yeah, what a horrible idea. Call him Beanie instead.
So Bob, thank you for sending that. That really gave us a chuckle. Next, we heard from Coaster Dean, our buddy. Ooh. And Coaster Dean said, note to self, never ask Matt Eckert to pet sit.
So yeah.
Be fair, I did nothing to these pets.
What pets are we talking about?
Yeah, including love them.
Miss them.
Yeah.
I liked our dog at home. I've talked about him.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. He says anything that licks, he doesn't like. No. So he likes holla dog, but otherwise he doesn't like. And you don't like birds?
No.
But
birds scare me. Birds freak me out.
Birds scare you. But they had a parakeet that
I didn't have a parakeet. My sisters had a parakeet.
That escaped in a house fire.
Yeah.
And then you had a skunk. That was a really sad ending. We were really upsetting
her. What kind of pets do you have? You're like Ace Ventura.
My brothers and sisters were like Ace Ventura. I had nothing to do with them. Like, that was not.
See, I'm with you on birds, though.
Birds?
Yeah, that's like Lori Cotton hates birds, too.
Birds just freak me out.
Okay, so we also heard from Brian Bird.
Oh. I like that bird.
Who is on Twitter, at Brian W. Bird. He said, Matt, I'm all ears for your love of beagles, but your bird hate ruffles my feathers.
But he's a B-Y-R-D, not a B-I-R-D.
Oh, okay. Hashtag hawk word, which was perfect. Hashtag toucan play at that game.
Very punny.
And
like
Brian
that.
Bird, as an aside, also is very artistic pumpkin carver. He has carved pumpkins using our logos and our roller coasters.
Cool.
And we use them year after year and always give him a shout out. So thank you. And we also heard from Alyssa Y on Twitter when she said, OMG, I want churro bites.
Oh, yeah.
That's amazing.
We had delicious churro bites last time, and they were very crunchy. And these two Yahoos. Like, we're right up against the microphone.
Are those new in the park? Churro bites?
They're so good. And they come with, like, chocolate, icing, raspberry. And raspberry sauce. Yeah, and you dip them. They dunk. Yeah, they're very good.
Next to Dole Whip, that might be my new favorite thing. They were really good.
They were really, and they were really good even when they weren't warm anymore.
They were.
Because I usually don't get to sample anything till after we're done. So by then, you know, I'll try to keep things going so we don't have to listen to you chewing. And but they were delicious even hours later.
Yeah.
We also heard from Zach Fuller at Zach ZB Fuller saying, Holiday World, if bacon land can't happen, then can we have chocolate land?
Chocolate covered
bacon could be served.
We were so close. That was the first time someone said bacon.
Eric always wants us not to talk about bacon.
Oh, we talk about it.
Chad, do you like bacon?
I love bacon.
It's great. It's great.
Then why do you want us not to talk about it?
Because I just one day.
There's
just
bacon on our sandwiches.
So you've consumed bacon potentially today.
Okay, that's eight times we've just said it. So just keep going.
Are you counting? Right.
Bacon, did you have bacon, an incident bacon, with bacon, bacon no, as
we,
a child?
We just talked about it heavily on
and
the
And people
podcast.
Send us samples. We have had bacon soda.
Bacon don't ever drink it.
We don't want to oversaturate the market. We
bacon cotton candy.
We've had bacon cotton candy.
Don't eat it.
Which is.
See, I think that sounds amazing.
No.
It's not what you think.
We've had some really good bacon products, but some of them are like that.
But as we heard last time on the podcast, we need to continue to try those things because it helps the economy in so many different ways.
Oh, yeah,
yes,
you
Matt's
and your stats.
All about, yeah, Matt brought in this article and read it to us.
Baconflation. Oh, my gosh.
But my husband, Gary, enjoyed that immensely. I was like, oh, gosh, I have to sit and listen to this again. But thank you.
It's real.
Yes, he was very excited about that. We heard again from Coaster Dean, and I think this was more directed at you than anyone else. Lauren was on April 15th. You catching this, Holiday World? And he was sharing the birth of April's baby. April the giraffe had her baby.
I saw it.
And oh,
my mother was obsessed with that.
Yeah.
No, you don't understand. In fact, she has a smart TV, and I went over to her house to visit one Sunday, and I walked in and April the giraffe was on the smart TV. She was like 55 feet wide. What are you doing? She's like, well, she studied all the like Facebook posts. She knew about the doctors and she knew what to look for. And I got a text message the day of the birth that said, I see two hooves. I'm like, are you kidding me? This is the text message I get on a Saturday morning as I see two hooves.
Yeah. Just like, I saw that too. Like,
oh my gosh.
So now is April going to have like postpartum depression now that she's not getting all this attention anymore?
No, seriously. I'm pretty sure my mother registered for Gibson
Tower. I think they put them back up. I think they started up again. The live cam is back. I saw
for what?
The
is she pregnant
really?
Again?
No, just
seriously.
Well, surely not. Well, I mean, it took her 15 months.
I know, that's what I'm saying. Seriously. Maybe she's just
them walking around in the pen.
I will say, marketing geniuses grow. Though, because did you all realize that they had like Toys R yes. Us was the yep. as soon as that
oh smart.
Cat was born, babies are us. The logo changed yep. immediately.
Oh yep. smart. Smart!
As soon as that thing hit the ground. Logo change.
That is cool.
We also got a post on Facebook saying, such a good podcast. Thanks, Pod Squad. One of my all-time favorite Holiday World rides, the Banshee, was mentioned in this episode. We did this to ourselves,
it's
you
like
guys.
Bacon.
Which left me like wondering, bacon. What happened to the Banshee? Hmm. What did happen to the Banshee?
The Banshee, if you missed the Banshee, you can still ride it. It's actually out at Cliffs Amusement Park in Albuquerque, New Mexico.
The same right. one.
The Banshee the did not one. Like our weather.
The Banshee did not like our weather.
Especially right. last year.
It didn't
was
like to operate.
2002 was the last year it was here, but that people all these years
has
later.
Has it really been that long?
Yes.
Oh,
yeah, Hollow Swings was new in 2003.
But I remember.
Still, we still get asked about it.
I remember the next year, Dad came home and said, he's like, you'll never believe this. He's like, you know how we sold the Banshee? And I'm like, yeah. He's like, they say it's running fine. Like, it hasn't had a down day all year. And I'm like, are you freaking kidding me?
In New Mexico?
In New Mexico.
Yeah.
Well,
is it really dry? It is perfectly fine with the dry weather.
And I think
did not want to ride in our weather.
Isn't the park just open maybe 3 days a week or something?
Open.
So
yeah,
it's not quite the grueling hours that, I guess I shouldn't use the word grueling. Looking forward to the start of the season.
Right, wait for Saturday. Wait 2 days.
But giving rides day after day during the daily season in the hot, humid weather, you could see where poor Banshee just said, that's enough.
Yep.
I also got a direct message on Twitter from Larry R. that I was hoping maybe someone here could help me figure out what it means. Love this place. Thank you, Larry R. Great dirt, the kids, and reasonable too. Great dirt.
Great dirt. The kids and Reasonable too.
So I don't know what the dirt is. We're still the cleanest park, last I checked. But
yeah, but our soil is really nice.
It is. We have really good dirt.
We have great dirt. So that kind of ties in with the whole,
sure,
you know, what ride are we going to add when it was Thunderbird was the dirt.
Yeah.
So we have great dirt.
There was a guy tilling up the dirt today at Firecracker. It looked really good.
Yeah.
Thank you, Larry R.
Getting everything. So I'm not sure. But it was a direct message. So that's kind of more of a private message. So I don't know what that meant. And finally, we heard from the coaster crew.
Yes.
Who wants to take a minute and explain to Chad what the coaster crew is all about.
Okay. So the coaster crew, well, it's actually a group of roller coaster enthusiasts.
It's a club.
It's a club, yes. Just like Ace and some of the other ones, yes. So, but we had a few of the members attend Halloween Nights last year, and we had found this costume character foot in the previous entertainment director's office, and she had had it since the day she started. She has no idea where it came from, why we have it. It doesn't match any of our characters, and it's just one. It's not a pair. It's just 1 foot. And she'd been toting it around for years. And so she was finally like, can I get rid of this? And I was like, I'm going to sell it in the Halloween Nights auction. So I did. And two guys from the coaster crew bought it. And they proceeded to go around the park that night and take photos of the foot in different locations around the park.
Kind of photobombing everything.
Yes. And then they like posted them like to social media, and we were all like, this is amazing. But it didn't stop there.
It gets better.
Since then, like basically once a week, so for almost an entire year now, like every week they've been posting new photos with the foot doing different activities. And now like Hall Dog and Kitty and Sam and George have all joined in on the fun, like the little stuffed animal versions of them. Like, so just...
And they tie the in with the holidays.
They tie, yes.
Yeah. Tell them about the book.
Oh, yes. And so for like several of these, I've been saying, I want a coffee table book. Like, these need to be in a coffee table book because this is amazing. So for Christmas, they made me a coffee table book.
It's very well written.
It was amazing.
Really? Yeah, it was like, it had a story.
Yes, it had a story, and there were even photos that they didn't really like, they hadn't posted cause. Yet. Like, oh, it was like.
That's phenomenal. So, what does the foot look like? I mean, is it.
Well, I'm glad you asked.
Dark green foot,
which now has glasses, and they pose the green foot.
The funniest part about this is we have no idea where this foot came from.
Yeah, what is the character? Yes. I don't recall this ever in the history of this.
Do you think it was
park.
A sample for some sample
maybe?
Thing?
And then maybe. Just, maybe, I don't know.
You're supposed to
but
return it.
But it was just this random foot. It's not part of any of our
And it's not a gigantic
characters.
Foot.
It exists it for a reason.
It's the big green
foot. It's a big
foot.
Foot. Big
it's
foot.
It's the big green
costume character
foot.
Sized foot.
Was it like V1 of Safari Sam?
And so they always.
I don't think so.
It definitely was a holodog.
So we've also coined the cheese ball is now a verb because somebody once emailed me in reply to an e-newsletter that That's we sent true. Out. I'll bring the cheese ball.
I guess I didn't read it.
So it was kind of that the case of mistaken identity when you get the, because I'm sure you get random replies to things
sometimes.
That aren't meant for you. So we call that
cheese ball
because we get, especially with a name like Holiday World, on Twitter, we will get people tweeting us about Holiday World resorts in Spain or Holiday World travel agencies in Pakistan. And so there's always these just...
Pakistan.
Yes.
Oh, like everywhere around the world.
All around the world. So this particular tweet was hashtag cheeseballed. I got this request from a dissatisfied customer. Holodog just doesn't get it. National Cheeseball Day, which it was. Ho-o-po. So it's holodog with a cheese ball. And
also, is a holodog like, so it's like wearing a glove? Is that what's happening there? Like, it
looks
like
his arm.
I don't know. Sometimes they have to explain things to us.
Do they ever?
Like,
we ask.
I wonder if that's like a sanitary glove.
Yes, I bet it is.
We ask questions every time, and do they ever respond?
We get some
do
sort of explanation.
I bet it's a sanitary glove.
But I wonder if the cheese balling that went on using cheese ball as a verb is that somebody sent them a can of Jolly Green Giant peas, which Kitty Claus is trying to open with a can opener, and the big green foot, Jolly Green Giant. So that's kind of what we're thinking may be the case. But look, there's more. It wasn't just once. We also heard from the Coaster Crew on Easter. Let me get this. There you go, Lauren. The Easter foot doesn't use the bunny trail. I use the doggone trail. Sam is sure there are more treats at the bottom. Hashtag ho-o-po.
So they've got kitty space every time that gets me.
They've got the big green foot.
That's so funny.
She's terrified.
Has got a little bunny rabbit hat on. Safari Sam is upside down in the Easter basket, digging for good candy. And then Kitty Claws has bunny ears on. These will all be included in today's blog post.
Oh my gosh. I really love Sam just like head first in the basket. Yes,
a true chocolate lover.
That's how you do it.
And the foot's festive.
George looks happy too. Yes. He's very.
George is always happy.
The foot's festive outfit. Yeah.
I like George.
You like George?
Yeah.
As a bird.
A bird. Because he doesn't lick. Or flap his wings, or peck
because he's an eagle,
or carry avian flu.
Did you find out? Oh, did you tell him, Lauren, the color of that blue on Firecracker? Oh wait, never mind.
What? It's called dragonfly blue.
Oh no! Like on the darker blue on the platform.
What?
It's called eagle blue.
Mmm. Or birds.
Oh.
Sorry, Matt.
Well, the blue that I picked out was dragonfly.
Oh. Oops.
This was a story that went bad.
Wait, okay, never mind.
In Matt's defense on the birds, I do a lot of work with St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, and I was down in Memphis for a conference once, and the world's leading researcher and expert on avian flu spoke to our group.
Wow.
It was horrifying.
Yeah, I bet.
Seriously, it was at the Peabody Hotel, which is, famous for the ducks swim in the ground. Like, after hearing his speech, I offered to go shoot the ducks. I'm like, do I need to go, take care of them and get them out of here? I'm convinced these things are going to kill us all.
Wow.
Exactly.
I'm with you. So, see, there's a little bit of science behind your madness.
They shouldn't have done that.
There's a cardinal in Monsoon. We have a break room, and our guests enjoy it, too. It's an air-conditioned dining location, but we do trainings in there this time of year. And there's a cardinal that keeps trying. He always tries to get in through the windows and door.
Is he pecking on it?
And he isn't pecking. He's kind of just running into it.
Yeah.
So we go out to
he's going
to
eventually show him his deck.
Well, I know. And that's we try to get him to go away and he'll just sit there and watch us.
Don't they think it's another cardinal? Isn't it a territorial thing?
Yes.
Yeah. He thinks he's fighting with somebody.
He's fighting another cardinal. Something up in the window to block so it doesn't reflect.
Because the birds like to attack.
See, I just assumed he was trying to get in. So when he opens the door.
He sees himself and he thinks it's a foe.
Birds like to attack.
Don't they make a little eye stickers you can put on windows and the eyes scare the birds away?
Really?
I think so, yeah.
Well, I'm going to look into this now.
Yeah.
I felt very bad for him and we opened the door thinking he just needed to see that it wasn't a space.
Well, don't feel bad for him. He's a jerk. He's picking a fight.
Exactly. That's what I said.
He's an aggressive cardinal.
We're making friends with the birds.
Gosh. Okay. I tried to give you a nice story.
Did you know with our new Pick Your Price online ticket discounts, you could save up to $20 per general admission ticket? Did you know that, Chad?
Yeah, I did. That's a fun idea, too.
And save a little bit more by using the official Holiday World Podcast promo code HOWOPO. Let me spell that for you. HOWOPO. Simply go to HolidayWorld.com/save and drop in HOWOPO and let the savings begin.
Very cool.
Love it. We actually shared a story about your Pick Your Price effort, and holy cow, our listeners shared that thing like crazy on social media.
I saw that. Thank you. I did. I saw that. I remember sent that over to
ton of response.
Yeah, that was. Well, people are looking for a deal, and let's give it to them. So it's going really well. It's that time again. You've heard the theory of 6 degrees of separation, right, Chad?
Yes.
Well, it's been 33 years since we changed our name from Santa Claus Land to Holiday World, so let's play a game called 33 Degrees of Separation. Our passive-aggressive contestants are given the name of someone or something that is connected with the year 1984 and must figure out the connection to us. Does that make sense?
Okay, interesting.
You don't have to do it 33. You just have to connect.
You have to connect it to something about Holiday World.
Do I need a noisemaker now?
Yes.
Because
everybody's grabbing props.
Yes.
And we do need to announce last episode's winner, Matt Eckert. Congratulations, Matt.
Take that, Eckert.
Yes.
I was in first both times.
With bad answers.
But that's it. See, there's this ongoing discontent among...
Some people have advantages, Chad.
What does that mean?
No, I don't know.
Just picking a fight. You're like the cardinal, aren't you?
Yes.
I think you are.
Start running into the door. Do you see why I don't like birds?
So what we do is we'll have two rounds.
Okay.
And first we're going to go around and everybody can try their sound maker because whoever buzzes in or rattles in first gets to go first. So let's listen to what Chad brought.
I told you it had a little bit of Latin flavor.
Oh, Morocco, right? That's cool. Oh,
and Matt, let's hear your sound. He's been a cow for whatever reason.
It was an elephant. Then I changed
it was an elephant,
cow.
But we said, well, that's the mammoth, so that made sense.
That's
but.
What it used to be, right?
All right, Eric. Wow, it's a different whistle, isn't it?
I heard your feedback.
Okay. Thank you for listening. Yeah. And Lauren has her squeaky toy back. Very good.
That's really good.
At the end.
So,
that's a gasping. Few holes on the bottom.
Matt, don't freak out. That toy is normally used to summon pets who lick.
I know. Yeah. I know. The door is shut, though.
Edgar's coming. He's on
the door is closed.
So we will start in honor of Chad being our guest today. Both of these will be country hits from 1984.
Oh, you're going down, people.
No. Okay, but what we need to do is you need to take the name. All you need to know, so no one needs to have heard the song. You need take the name and find a way to tie it into Holiday World.
Okay, interesting.
All right. The first, so be ready with your sound maker because these guys are really aggressive. They're all three of them. Look at them. Look at their eyes are gleaming. The smiles are gone.
This is like when Jeopardy goes bad. I mean, it's
all right.
Turned us into monsters.
This was a country hit in 1984 by Earl Thomas Conley. The name of the song, Angel in Disguise. Matt, what was that all about?
Yes, Bessie. Okay.
Burped and growled.
Okay, Matt, you get to go.
So Angel in Disguise, when I think of disguise, I think of costumes. And when I think of costumes, I think of Halloween, which is one of our sections in Holiday World and Splash and Safari.
Okay, that wasn't it, but that's a great answer, Matt.
I like to think a lot of our hosts and hostesses are angels in disguise. They're making memories for guests every day. Don't roll your eyes at me.
That was a good one.
That was it. And I was, you got it. Keep talking.
Don't roll your eyes.
Nice.
No, but I did want to say, we've gotten some really amazing feedback from guests before, from somebody who just went a little above and beyond. It's amazing how the guests felt.
Can you give us an example? I'll give you an extra point.
Yes. One time there was, we had something going on at the park and we had to, have some, I don't know the best way to say this. Some people had to leave.
Okay. Oh, good example. I'll take that point away.
But we had to get some people out of a certain area and they were in the water park and they didn't have shoes. So one of our hosts gave them the shoes off their feet so they could leave the park and not step on the gravel. So a host gave them shoes so they would be, I think that's a really good story.
It is a very good story. All right.
Can I refute something he said though?
Sure.
I really don't think our hosts and hostesses are in disguise as angels. I think they're that great. I don't think they're hiding who they are.
Just stop sucking up.
Stop trying to undervalue my...
Eric had a really good answer. No one's going to top that. Just accept it.
On his side.
He got that. You got that. You nailed it. Is that the first time
he got
gotten something completely right?
No, I got it once. When he has gotten something.
Okay. Yeah.
God. But I think, no, the thought is,
I know
when we, it is, it's really,
yeah, thank you.
You have to go home and lie down after this
when somebody else says, God,
you've seen nothing yet.
Do you lose this game a lot and they just give you bacon as a party?
I don't usually win.
He's been getting better recently. But like whenever we first started playing, yes, it was a very long streak of Eric not winning ever.
Well, you guys started earlier than I did.
Well, yeah, you've been here, what, 2 years? Is this your third season?
Oh, I was going to say on the podcast?
No, at the park.
This will be
my
third
season. So you don't have
that
long history that the rest of us have.
So it's amazing what I've done.
Oh, it is.
That's what I did. You've come a long way, Eric. You get the most improved award.
Oh, my God. Everyone gets a trophy.
He's still going.
Yes. But yes, the thought was, and this is something I know we, in our training with our hosts and hostesses, is help them understand how their action or reaction to a guest can make their day or break their day. And how sometimes guests are visiting and they're going through a hard time or they've had a loss or something where you just going the extra mile or even doing something as simple as offering to take the photo for them. If dad's taking the photo of the family and you can step in and say, oh, would you like me to take that? And then dad's in the photo and just little things like that can be quite angelic.
Yes.
Mr. Eric or Mr. Eckert. Eric and Eckert, that's kind of close.
Yeah, I guess so. And when you're riding Voyage, you go so high in the sky. You know, basically reaching the height of the angels.
Oh, Eric, you took it too far.
Don't take a point away from me.
All right. Far.
You were there, isn't you?
All right.
Our not greedy.
Second country hit from 1984. I have to take a picture of everyone poised because it's really funny. I can't do it the way this table's set up.
I was just about to have a cheese curd.
All right, go ahead and get a cheese curd. Let me take a picture.
Rock it out for the picture.
All right. Matt, come on. Look at what Chad's doing.
Look at what Chad's doing.
Maybe I'll crap you out of this.
Come on, come on, Matt. Milk that cow.
No, if you hit it too soon, then she takes away a point.
I'll take away a point.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, it gets cut you jumped the gun.
Oh, I'm glad you don't shake that thing before you're ready to shake it.
I can't even make a slight movement.
All right, here we go. Our second country hit from 1984, a hit from the Kendalls.
Oh, my gosh.
Thank God for the radio. Eric Rents.
Well, at our park, as you'd like to call them, we use two-way radios. So thank God for the radio so we can communicate to one another and make sure we're being angels to everybody. And thank God Chad's here and he's part of the radio.
Oh, he stole my answer.
It clicked. As soon as you started shaking, I'm like, yes, connection.
I know. It clicked in my head, too.
And you were second, right?
Yeah, I was going to tie it into myself in Holiday World because it's by the Kendalls. That's my mom's maiden name. So,
that's really neat.
I may have been related to them. You never know.
It was a father-daughter team.
Think I know them.
They're really good. You think you probably do. You're probably roommates with
them. They're at the Cracker Barrel in Corden.
Yes, they are. So that's my connection. So I work at Holiday World and Splash and Safari, and my mother was a Kendall. And
that's fun.
So. Very nice. Chad, what have you got?
Well, I was just going to talk about how we have this partnership with radio. I mean,
yeah.
At WBKR, we're glad to be a part of Holiday World, and it's a match made in heaven, right here in Santa Claus.
That was it.
Take that.
It's pretty good, and he said it really good, too.
He did. Yeah. He's a professional.
Yeah.
How about you, Lauren?
I know the answer's been said, but while it's not technically the radio, while you're at the park, you get to listen to music throughout the park that was actually most of it chosen by myself, and I'd like to hope that you enjoy it.
Yes. Very much
and
so.
It sometimes plays on the radio, I bet, those songs.
Or they did at one point.
They did at one point. I was like, I don't know that many of them are real chart
currently
toppers.
There, yeah.
I do have a question that's been burning in my soul. Is are we going to be adding any particular favorite songs of mine to the Christmas sections music? It's Turkey Lurkey.
No,
that will not be ours.
See, how can this not be? Chad, you know that song, Chad, from Promises? It's Turkey Lurkey time from Promises, Promises.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
You don't like it, though, do you?
It's the best.
Matt's shaking his head. No. No, it'd be impossible to like that song.
I think
song.
The balance of power in this room is out of whack. We'll adjust these. But the answer was, thank God for the radio, because without the radio, we probably wouldn't know Chad. And we'd be sitting talking to an empty chair right now. But
that'd be embarrassing.
Thank you all for playing. The winner will be announced in 2 weeks after I tally up all my hash marks.
It isn't me.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I didn't make it this week either.
I thought I won last week, so I don't know what's going on.
No, not quite, Mr. Rents. Well, thank you for joining us again, Chad.
So much fun.
And we hope all you listeners will join us again in 2 weeks for the one with the lights on. Thank you to Stephen Rutherford for making us sound so good. Study hard for that drone exam, Mr. Rutherford. We got a drone. I can't wait. And thanks to all of you for listening. Please subscribe on iTunes, Google Play Music, iHeartRadio, Stitcher, and YouTube. And tell all your friends. And on behalf of our pod squad, Matt, Eric, Lauren, and Back to School Leah, thank you. And be sure to send us your feedback and questions on social media using the hashtag
HoWoPo.
Been listening to the official Holiday World podcast.
Welcome back. Did you enjoy your flight?
A production of Holiday World and Splash and Safari in Santa Claus, Indiana. Check out the latest episodes at holidayworld.com/podcast. Thanks for taking a ride with us.
And please come back to see us again soon.